Good evening and welcome to the 29th annual Harry Jerome Awards. I'm Sharon and I'll be your host tonight as we celebrate one of the most anticipated and prestigious award events. So stay tuned for an amazing evening.
Whenever I need you, you're always there. You're even there the times I didn't even know you're there.
Right now, we are joined with Mr. Glenn Lewis himself. Welcome.
Hey, thank you. Thank you. Good to be here.
So is this your first time at the Harry Jerome Award?
As a matter of fact, it is. It feels really prestigious. It has that air to it. You know, a lot of important figures from our community and just at large, you know, it's an honor to be able to be here. As much as that sounds cliche, everybody says that kind of a thing. But to be able to be here amongst so many influential individuals within our community is great. It's great to be able to rub shoulders with everybody and celebrate all the accomplishments that they've made over the past year.
Tell us, what will you be doing here tonight?
Well, as a matter of fact, I was honored with the invite to be able to come down and perform the latest single off of my new album project that's coming in late summer. Title of the track's called Good Ones. Just recently shot the video.
Did you shoot here in Toronto, or?
Yeah, as a matter of fact, I kept it home base, and I worked with the brilliance of homegrown director Evan Winter, and you know, really looking forward to it. You know, it's been a while, been on hiatus like for the past 6-7 years, so I'm excited. Hey, what's up, folks? This is Glenn Lewis, and you're watching Yush TV. Keep it locked right here.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
My name is Jade Jagger-Clark. I'm the owner and artistic director of Jade's Hip Hop Academy, and I'm the recipient of the Harry Jerome Young Entrepreneur Award.
So what do you think that this award will bring to you in terms of, you know, it's a great achievement and a claim to your life? How do you think it'll change it?
Well, it's definitely a really great honor, and to receive that kind of recognition from the community is definitely very inspirational. So it gives you more motivation and more drive to keep going, and we've been able to... More people are now aware about us and what we do.
Maybe our viewers may or may not know, but Jade started her dance academy at the young age of 18 while still in school full time. That's amazing. What inspired you to do that and become an entrepreneur at such a young age?
Well, to be honest with you, it was always a hobby that I'd had since I was 14. I started teaching and dancing and choreographing then, and I became tired of teaching kids on a drop-in basis. So I was really looking to establish my own space where kids could come and learn and grow on a consistent basis, and I was lucky enough to find a space, and yeah, it just was something I really wanted, and from a hobby at 18 while I was in school, it just really grew into a full-time business. The studio is located in Brampton, right on the intersection of 410 and Steeles, so we have a lot of people come. Yeah, so we're right by the highway, so people as far as Guelph coming to train, Toronto, Mississauga, Orangeville, all over. Our website is www.jadeshiphopacademy.com, and definitely look us up at YouTube as well. We have a variety of videos there, so people can sort of get a sense of exactly what we do.
Perfect. We are live at the Harry Jerome Awards, and right now we are joined with Dalton McGinty. Thank you so much for doing a interview with Yush TV.
It's a pleasure, Sharon.
Is this your first time at the Harry Jerome Awards?
No, I think this is my 6th or 7th time.
Wow, great.
And the reason I love it is because it's an opportunity to celebrate excellence.
Yes.
And it's also an opportunity to rekindle people's memory a little bit about this guy, Harry Jerome.
Yes.
I think it was the 1964 Tokyo Summer Olympics. He was an outstanding sprinter. He brought home an Olympic medal for us. We lost him far too early.
He sure did.
But now we're allowing his memory and his perseverance and his achievements and his determination to inspire others. So I love the fact that we're recognizing people in the black community who've achieved, and I love what it does to young people. You know, really what the message we're sending to young people is hold your heads high, reach high, achieve, strive for excellence.
So tell us, now that you've been here several different times, what do you think is the most important message, other than carrying on his achievements and living on his dream, for everyone here, especially the award recipients tonight?
Well, the whole evening, of course, is a rich experience. There's more than just the awards themselves. There's entertainment. You're going to find such a wonderful collection of people here. Everything from the service sector, everything from policing to real estate, to people working at the cutting edge of medical research, to young entrepreneurs, to young artists. Everybody's here, and there's so much negativity, it seems, at different times in the media. It's nice to come to the occasional event where we celebrate all those good things that we've got going for us, and this is one of those opportunities.
Well, with everything going on right now, we're glad that you could come and make it out to the awards ceremony tonight and take some time out to celebrate the excellence of our community. So thank you very much.
It's an honor to be here. Thank you.
And do you have a message for our viewers at Yush?
Keep yushing.
We are back live on the red carpet, and right now we are joined with Mr. William Blair, the Chief of Police. Thank you very much.
It's always a pleasure. Thank you very much. Good evening.
And welcome to the Harry Jerome Awards. Is this your first time?
No, not nearly. This is a very important event, and I have been coming to the Harry Jerome Awards for many years. As a matter of fact, some of the members of my service and good friends have been recognized by the Harry Jerome Awards, and we know this is a great celebration, and we're always honored to have the opportunity to be here and to join in the celebration.
Well, that's great. Thank you very much. So tell us tonight, is there someone that you are here to support, or everyone you're here to support?
Well, I'm quite honest with you, we're here to support everyone, but I'm always particularly enthusiastic about the awards that go to the young people, because recognizing the potential of youth and their capacity to do some of the most extraordinary things, their leadership is really, we often so much talk about youth as our future, but they're our present too.
It's so true, and that's very well said. Can you tell our viewers how you may, for example, give back to the society in terms of the police?
Well, I can tell you that the police have a very distinct role in maintaining safe communities. So we're law enforcers, for example. We do patrols, we respond to emergencies. But I believe the police also have a responsibility to contribute to social justice in our city and to work on those things that help make communities better places to live, to improve the quality of life, to help young people realize their full potential, and to make sure that every young person, regardless of where they live, can be proud of the school they go to, proud of the neighborhood they're from, and they can make the right choices that are going to help them be great citizens in the city. And I think the police have a role to play in that. And we're always pleased that we have the opportunity to work with our community partners, because without that, we would just be the uniforms that show up in the corner when things go bad. But we're given so many opportunities by great partners in our community to come out and engage with young people, to come out and engage with our communities, to make that connection and to make a difference.
So what do you think tonight, since we are honoring the Harry Jerome Awards, would be an appropriate message from yourself to the viewers?
Well, I think it's important to remind all of the citizens of our city of the great contribution that is made by so many. And when we celebrate some of our finest examples of citizenry and finest examples of entrepreneurship, community involvement, and leadership, this is a good time to reflect of all the potential and the hope that exists in our city for a great future. And to remember that, if we just read the first few pages of the newspaper, watched the first couple of minutes on the news, we would think that we were in trouble, and we're not. We have a great city. We have great young people. We have a remarkable future ahead of us, and we should embrace that. We should support it in every way we can, and we should be proud of who we are as a city. This is a city where people come from all over the world to live in safety and peace and in harmony, and tonight we celebrate that.